エウルエエウルエエウルキニオハバイクワウリオカネメカナロワウルワエカオヒアクマクワエウルキニエウルエエウルエフハ。
When I think about Ohia, and when I think about what it means to me, I think about all of her stories that she had, and of it takes me back to the first one I've learned of her, of two lovers being split apart. And so when the flower gets taken away, she starts to cry. And I used to go down to my neighborhood park and pick this flower thinking that it was Ohia, and I was wrong. And growing up, like 18 years,never knowing who really Ohia was until finally I went to Waimea Valley. And there I met Ohia. She had these long arms. She was tall. She was short. She had flowers of all these different colors. And what really stood out to me the most was within her branches itself, there was these mosses growing and these other sprouts growing. And she was just bringing life. And the more I learned about her, the way I learned how she, herthe moss and the bark and the way she's soft, it soaks up the water and brings it down into our mountains to not only feed us, but to be able to wash out and feed these water birds like the alaiula that I love. And then up in her branches, she has these pua that are filled with sweet nectar for all these, not only native forest birds, but non-native forest birds, just really reaching out and having an abundance of food. And just how this one treeThat from the story of two lovers that weren't together in my past, comes to find out that she isn't just an embodiment of that, but she's just an embodiment of a community as a whole. To be able to not only hold yourself up and be able to provide for yourself, but be able to create enough abundance that you can have plants and animals and other creatures live amongst you.And have a fun time. So that's what Ohia means to me.